So today's problem statement is Turing machine accepting all strings in the form A raised to n, B raised to m, where the sigma is, where the sigma equal to A comma B. Inputs are A comma B. Okay. Now in the Turing machine, we can use this input symbol as well as we can use our own symbols, which is called as a tape symbol, additional symbol we can use while we are performing the operation. So with this problem, accepting all the strings in the form of A raised to n, B raised to n, A raised to n, B raised to n, this problem we have solved with the number of ways. So we will use the same problem to understand the Turing machine. Now A raised to n, B raised to n, suppose this is the input A, 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 B, B, B. So number of A's equal to number of B's and A is followed by B. So how we can check all the A's are equal to number of B's? So here we'll use some logic. Now the Turing machine, designing a Turing machine is all about the understanding the problem and finding out the logic for solving that problem. Now here, as I told, the head is always at the first symbol, first input symbol. Now what we'll do, we'll replace A's with a symbol called as X and B with the Y. We are using two more symbols, X and Y. So what we'll do, we'll read X, A, replace it with X. We'll just move at the end from right hand side. We'll start with the if B, replace it with the Y. Again come to here, again next A, make it X, move to the end, find next B, make it Y. Again come here, next A with replace with X, come here, next B, replace with the Y. And when there is no A and B, it means that yes, we have reached to the end. So that time we'll check the condition whether they are equal or not. This is a simple logic. What is our logic? We'll start from here. This A will replace with X. This A with replace with X. Skip A, skip A, skip B, skip B, skip B. Now when we reach to the blank, what it indicates? We are at the end. So when we are reaching to the blank, we'll keep blank as it is because we don't want to work with the blank. So we'll keep the blank as it is and we'll just change the direction so that we'll get the last alphabet. Okay. So how to get the last alphabet? This logic, just remember this logic, because in many problems we'll require this data. So how to find the last alphabet? Skip everything. When we are getting the blank, keep blank as it is and change the direction. Turn to the left. That will give you the last alphabet. Now this is B. Just replace this B with the Y. Replace the B with the Y. Then skip B, skip B, skip A, skip A. Now when we are getting X, now this A is replaced by X now. So this is X. So when we'll get X, just keep X as it is and turn to right. Change the direction. This X keep as it is and change the direction. So now we'll get this A. Replace this A with X again. Skip, skip, skip. Now what will be the last B now? Now where we'll get Y, keep Y as it is and change the direction. We'll get this B. Now this B, replace it with the Y. Skip B, skip A. Till while we are skipping this A and B, till we are getting the X. Because after that X, we will get the required A. So when we'll reach to X, keep as it is, change the direction. So we'll get this A. A, replace it with X. Skip B. Now we have reached Y. Keep as it is, change the direction. So we are now here B. So this B, replace it with X, Y. Replace this B with a Y. Left. Left we are getting X. So we are keeping X as it is and changing the direction right. But again, at the right, we are getting y. There is no a. We are getting y. What it means? We have come to the condition that is the end. This is the logic which we have to implement for our Turing machine. That is for a raised to n, b raised to n. Okay. Now we will try to develop, implement this logic into the designing of Turing machine. Now, how we are starting? We'll just again, we'll design the Turing machine. Same time we'll write this. So always your Turing machine start with the Q0. Is the initial state. Q0 is the initial state. Now after Q0, how we are starting? Initially your read-write head is here. What we are doing? We are getting A. So replace this A with the X. So we'll Q1. Replace this A. Input is A. Replace with the X. And which direction the head has to move? Onto the right direction. So replace this A with the X. And the head will now be here. So first A is replaced with the X. Now head is at A. So now A, what we have to do? We have to skip A. Now skipping means what? Keeping the A as it is. Keeping the A as it is means what? A replaced with A. And which direction we have to move? Right. This A as it is. So A replaced with A. So it will be skipped as it is. So now head will be here. Again we are getting A. So again we have to skip. A replaced with A, again right. So all A's we are getting. So we'll skip all A's. So A replaced with A and right. So this will be in a loop. So A replaced with A, right. A replaced with A, right. So that we will make it is a loop. So we'll make this A replaced with A and move right. Okay. So now head will be here. So A replace. So Q1 state. So by replacing all A with A only, we are here. Now what we are getting here? B. So what we have to do with B? We have to start replacing from the end. So this B again will skip. How the skip operation we are writing? Replace B, input B, replace with B and move right. B, replace with B, move right. B replace with B, move right. Okay. So all B we have to skip. So again for B, input B, skip, replace B, right. B. So that will be again in a loop. So it will be again with the same loop. B, if we are getting B, replace with the B and say right. So that will skip all B. So after replacing first A with X, move right. If I am getting A, skip it. If I am getting B, skip it. So whatever we are getting, we are skipping. Okay. So B, and what head movement is very important. Head movement is very important. Now we are here. By skipping all B's. Now which input I am getting around here, we'll get the B, blank. So this is the blank. So if I am getting blank, it means we have reached to the end. Now we have to make direction as a left so that the last alphabet of my input I will get. Okay. So this blank, keep as it is and just change the direction of the head. So we'll move to the Q2. So what this Q2 operation is, if I am getting this blank, keep this blank as it is. And what will be the direction of the head now? Left. The direction of head will be left. So now my head is here. The Turing machine's head is here. Okay.